A conversation about race on Joe Rogan's podcast taking an uninformed turn. A guest on the show, psychologist and commentator Jordan Peterson, questioned the racial identity of prominent black professor Michael Eric Dyson. You may have seen Dyson on this program before. So take a listen to what happened on that podcast.
Depending on who you ask, either you're a voice of reason and rationality and personal responsibility, or you're a voice of intolerance and bigotry and anger and hateful.
Sexual oppression.
What did Michael
prejudice.
Eric Dyson call you? A mean, angry white man?
A mean, angry white man. Yeah.
Hilarious.
Yeah, yeah.
You're not mean at all. Yeah, yeah. That's what's dumb about that statement. You're not mean at all.
I am white. Actually, that's a lie, too. I'm kind of tan. And he was actually not black.
If you're tan,
he was
what
sort
the
of
f- am I? Because I'm darker than you.
Yeah, yeah.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah, yeah. But neither of us are white.
Well, I'm Italian.
And he was brown, not black.
Well, isn't that weird?
Yeah, it's really weird.
The black and white thing is so strange because like the shades are so...
Tan and brown.
There's such a spectrum of shades of people. Unless you're talking to someone who is like 100% African from the darkest place where they're not wearing any clothes all day and they've developed all that melanin to protect themselves from the sun. You know, even the term black is weird. And when you use it for people that are literally my color, it becomes very strange.
Okay. Michael Eric Dyson, professor of African American Diaspora Studies at Vanderbilt University, joins me now. He's the author of Entertaining Race, Performing Blackness in America. Hello, professor. Thank you for joining us. So your name was dropped because here's why. Because you have previously debated Jordan Peterson. But yeah, and they mentioned it, right? You said you were an angry white man or something like that. Or mean, I forget. Let's go beyond these two guys. Talk about what's really happening here. Is it really that perplexing to people that black America exists in all kinds of shades? That doesn't change the black experience in America.
Not at all. Thank you for having me, Brother Don. You know, you would hope they were joking, because if they weren't, this exposes the vast lethal ignorance at the heart of so much whiteness, whether intentional or not. We all know that black is not a phenotypical reality. We're not talking about a genetic predisposition toward darker skin. We're speaking about an existential context. We're talking about a philosophical idea. We're speaking about rooted cultures in deep histories that have vast traditions that have generated complicated identities. And we know that blackness, in terms of its identity, ranges from vanilla vitality to chocolate charm, and all ranges in between. So it's not about shade. It's not about a kind of inherited characteristic of race. Race is, as we've been arguing in school, and I would advise Dr. Peterson and Brother Rogan to take a class. When we talk about race as a social construct, what we're saying is it's not about a biological determinism. It's about an inherited set of beliefs that depend upon a society to imbue it with meaning. And therefore, it's not simply about who you are, your skin color, your hair, your shade, and tone. Now, while they unsuccessfully challenged my blackness, they damn sure proved their whiteness, indifferent to history, oblivious to truth, and indifferent to reality.
Mm-hmm. So it was kind of a weird thing to say, to refer to people as black. That's what he said. It's weird to refer to people as black unless they are from Africa, not wearing any clothes. There's a fundamental misunderstanding, you know, as you've been pointing out, of what it means to be black.
Absolutely. They're hearkening back to Joseph Conrad's Heart of Darkness. Brother Rogan is smarter than that. People who are in Africa who don't wear clothes, who have deeper melanin, was he speaking about thousands of years ago? Is he talking about today when he refers to what it means to be African, when he refers to what it means to be black? Are you that obtuse, indifferent to truth, ignorant about traditions? But yes, so many people are. This is the same kind of ignorance that fuels the belief that CRT is being taught in elementary school. This is the same kind of ignorance that would have us believe that 1619 is an anti-democratic, anti-American project. This is the nature of the whiteness we continually confront. This is willful ignorance. This is not, oh my God, I just don't understand it, it's too complicated. No, what's too complicated is to acknowledge your whiteness, your privilege, your perspective, the shades through which you view the world, and the ways in which whiteness provides a kind of lens through which we view it. So well, yeah, they know better than that.
I mean, do they know better than that? Because look, we all speak for a living. That's what I do for a living. So, you know, at times you screw up. And so I like to give people grace when they speak for a living because, sure. You know, especially that's he has a podcast. I'm not sure how long it is or how long he goes, but you're just sort of speaking off the cuff. But one would think that you would do your research if you're going to talk about topics that are this sensitive and this important. But do they know better or are they just speaking to the people in their audience and just sort of capitalizing on that thinking that's what they want to hear? Do you understand what I'm saying?
Sure, absolutely. And I don't think those things are mutually exclusive. I think on the one hand, you're absolutely right. They're speaking to their audiences. They're ginning up a kind of resistance and a kind of anger at, look at this guy talking this kind of stuff. And blackness is much more complicated. And look, by the way, he's lighter than us or darker than us, and therefore he's not really black. Come on. So yeah, they're playing to the ignorance of their audience, but they're also, exposing a kind of lethal ignorance about the very nature of race itself. And they, in that sense, yeah, they know better. Look, I met Joe Rogan and spoke to him after a concert by Dave Chappelle. You're opening for Dave Chappelle, one of the blackest men in America, not because of his brown skin tone, not because of the shade of his skin, but by virtue of the ideals he promotes, the ideals with which he wrestles, and the ways in which he gets it right, or some would say
and
wrong.
And his life experiences.
And life experiences and the way in which he channels those. So Joe Rogan, you're opening up for a guy who has redefined for many people blackness in the last 15 years, and yet you're claiming not to know what blackness is. Yeah, I think that's a deliberate, willful ignorance, and it's the unintentional hilarity of a certain kind of whiteness that refuses to own up to what it is. Because if he refuses to acknowledge my blackness, he doesn't have to confront his whiteness. The moment he acknowledges that I am a black man, he has to confront the fact that he is a white man. And in order to deflect that and to defer that and to defend his whiteness, he would rather disappear it. As Gore Vidal said, we live in the United States of amnesia. And my brother Joe Rogan and Dr. Peterson from Canada are parts of that, you know, United States of amnesia, the Canadian virtue and province of amnesia. This is what we're talking about, a willful, whiteful, a white disregard for the truth before them.
I hope he has you on to talk about it, because I think you'd be great.
I mean, I would love to be on Joe Rogan's show, but I don't think, look, he wants to talk behind my ear. He doesn't want to talk to my face. Because, you know, I'd have to challenge some of that stuff. But I would love to engage him and would love to talk about it and helpfully educate himself, our audiences, myself, and the whole of us as we try to grapple with what it means to be black and to have race in an American society.